Hi, let's talk about the major thoracic veins in the root of the neck. The caval system references all of the blood flowing into either the inferior or the superior vena cava. So it's the blood that's being drained from systemic circulation and being returned to the right atrium of the heart. The superior vena cava has a few major tributaries or branches that flow directly into it. The first, and not pictured here, is the Aziz vein. The Aziz vein is the major tributary of the Aziz system, which drains the posterior thoracic wall. The major contributors to the superior vena cava are the left brachiocephalic vein and the right brachiocephalic vein. Notice that the left brachiocephalic vein is longer and more oblique than the right brachiocephalic vein. As you can see, now it's draining things from left of the midline, and so to get to the superior vena cava takes quite a bit of distance. Now, each of these brachiocephalic veins has two major tributaries, and I'll just outline them here on the left. The internal jugular vein and the subclavian vein. The subclavian vein is returning blood from the upper limb as well as the head and neck as well as the thorax, and it receives an external jugular vein. The external jugular vein rides over the sternocleidomastoid muscle and is a sometimes visible vein on the superficial portion of the lateral neck. You can see here is the external jugular vein or the EJV there, and there's the sternocleidomastoid reflected away. There's the IJ, and there's the subclavian vein. Now, wherever the subclavian vein meets the IJ, we have what's known as the venous angle. So there are right and left venous angles, and these are important for understanding lymphatics because it's in the vicinity of the venous angle that we have the lymphatic ducts and sometimes the trunks independently re-entering the vasculature. So they're delivering lymph into venous supply. So this is a very high level look at the major veins of the root of the neck for the thorax. Thank you very much for your time.